So there has been a lot of buzz in the last few years about orcas attacking great whites, with helicopter and drone footage showing a predation event from the air. And to be honest, I was a little surprised at the level of surprise people seem to have that orcas hunt great white. I thought this had been common knowledge for at least a few decades. After all, in the film Jaws, a movie that came out in 1975, the boat used to go out and kill the nefarious great white was called Orca. And I'm pretty sure on some DVD bonus feature or something, it said the boat had the name Orca because Orca is the only natural predator of the great white. But it turns out this was more something scientists suspected rather than an actual fact. Of course, there were stories and accounts from fishermen and the like, but it wasn't until October 4th, 1997, off the coast of the Farallon Islands, near San Francisco, that we get the first documented sighting of killer whales eating white sharks, or at least their livers. And of course, in the last few years, we've seen a number of great white sharks washing up on the shores of South Africa, with their livers removed, and we have the aerial footage I mentioned before. And it makes sense that the orcas are the ones taking out the great whites. Your typical orca is bigger than a white shark, but most importantly, the thing that orca have on their side is numbers. Some orca pods go up to 40, but even much smaller ones are incredibly lethal, as they can coordinate attacks. Now, while new studies suggest some whites hunt in pairs, it's not at the same level as the hyper-intelligent orca. However, orcas definitely have the advantage, no doubt there. But this does pose an interesting question. Do great whites ever fight back? And if so, do they ever win? Now, before we get deeper into this video, I just want to thank my amazing patrons for their support, and I would also like to give a shout out to a subscriber who goes by CDs for the idea for this video. They left some really interesting comments talking about the idea, and they are the reason I'm making this video. They actually have a YouTube channel and upload videos about wolf spiders that they keep. Pretty cool stuff, so make sure to check them out. Now, to determine whether or not white sharks could ever stand a chance against orca, we should probably look at the challenges they have to overcome. So let's start with the biggest one. Numbers. Like I said, orca can travel in groups of up to 40, but luckily for sharks, from what we've seen so far, it doesn't look like they have to deal with that number. In the infamous drone footage from 2022, the great white was being pursued by 5 orca. Which is of course still a lot to deal with, but it seems that the main shark eaters are 2 orca, by the name of Port and Starboard. These are 2 male orcas that have been targeting white sharks for a number of years. They got their names from their collapsed dorsal fins. Port's collapses to the left, and Starboard's to the right. It's actually somewhat rare to see collapsed dorsal fins in the wild, and no one is exactly sure why these 2 guys are like this. It could be due to some injury, or it might be because they're not getting enough calcium from their high shark liver diet. Now, they are not the only orca that target white sharks. They're not the first either, but they have been very prominent in the last few years, and are seemingly responsible for the majority of white shark attacks off the coast of South Africa. It's not just white sharks. They also target copper sharks and broadnose seven-gill sharks. Again, for that liver. In 2023, they apparently killed 17 seven-gill sharks in a single day. And here's the first clue as to whether or not the great whites can fight back. Footage from a Nat Geo documentary in 2020 shows orca hunting seven-gills off the coast of New Zealand. And interestingly, the seven-gills fight back. Or at least they try to. They aren't very successful. But could a great white do any better? The average length of a broadnose is about 2.2 meters or 7.2 feet, and the max is about 3 meters or 9.8 feet, with a max weight of something like 107 kilos or 236 pounds. So I would consider them a sizable shark, but they are dwarfed in comparison to a large female white shark. Big female white sharks can, in some cases, grow over 6 meters or around 20 feet and weigh up to 1110 kilos or 4200 pounds. Now that would mean you get a lot more shark liver, but it would be a bigger risk. On the Discovery Shark Week show, Robert Irwin and a team of marine biologists measured the bite force of a big female at 2000 newtons. Now this female wasn't a 20 footer, so an even bigger white should have even more power. But the bottom line is, even with a lot of blubber protection, an orca probably wouldn't want to get bitten by a big white shark. So if a big white shark was getting attacked by the two orca, is it possible she could get a couple of bites in and at the very least scare them off? Now I realize I've been focusing on a lot of ideas and theories so far, but let's get something clear. Do we actually have any evidence of a white shark surviving an orca attack? Actually, yes, we do. A paper published in Marine Biological Journal in 2023 describes a white shark that was photographed off of False Bay in 2017. The interesting thing about this white shark, though, is that it has bite marks that seem to have come from orca. In fact, the author, A. de Madalena, believes it was from Port and Starboard, or at least one of them, I guess, as they were active in the area in 2017. That was when they killed the 17 Seven Guilds in a day, and again, not all orca target sharks. Now, even though this white shark had been attacked, it seemed to be doing fine. To quote the paper, apart from the rake marks, the shark appeared to be perfectly fine, swimming normally and being very active and fast. The paper also states, this observation is especially interesting because it represents the evidence that great white sharks can survive an attack by an orca, and it does not necessarily have to succumb in the confrontation between the two species. So what did the white shark do? How did it survive the attack? The female was a 3.5 meter, or about 11.5 feet in length. Not a small shark, but not really a giant either. It's also not the only known survivor. In the aforementioned Nat Geo show, Orca vs. White Shark, they film a male great white shark with teeth marks on his dorsal fin that the two marine biologists are very certain came from an orca bite. So how did they survive the attacks? The thing is, usually when orca attack and devour a great white, all other white sharks in the area get the heck out of there and they don't return for weeks or even months. Sharks disappear for a while when the attacks happened at the Farallons, and of course they fled from the coast of South Africa too. There is some speculation as to how the sharks knew the orca had made a kill. Perhaps it was the pieces of shark tissue in the large slick that sharks smelt and swam away from, or maybe it was orca calls, or perhaps both. There is a separate Nat Geo documentary called Great White vs. Killer Whale. I know it's confusing as both documentaries have similar names, but in this one, they did an experiment where they dipped bait in a compound similar to a shark slick, and a white shark bit into it but repeatedly spat it out, so maybe the slick has some effect? But anyway, getting back to the survivors, if they didn't leave in time to avoid the confrontation, did they fight off the orca? Sharks can be territorial. Did these ones stand their ground? Well, there was another experiment, this time from the other documentary, Great White vs. Orca. They went to an area in the waters off of New Zealand where there were some white sharks and played different sounds. First, humpback whale songs. And the sharks love that, coming right up to the cage looking for some humpback to eat. The shark that had the orca bite mark even showed up. Then they played sounds of orca from North America that eat salmon, and the sharks didn't seem to care. Again, not all orca target sharks. Then they play the sounds of New Zealand orca, orca that the great whites have probably heard before, and the shark seemed to flee. But then, a big female showed up. Could this mean bigger females hold their ground against orca? Could large females and even large males fight back, and on some occasions it's enough to scare the orca away? Well, I'm not so sure. You see, coming into this with just a little bit of knowledge, I was expecting, and maybe hoping, that that would be the conclusion, that some big great white sharks fight off orca. But before we go to that conclusion, let's look at some details a little closer. See, that shark off the coast of Mozzle Bay that was killed was estimated to be about 3 meters long, and I thought maybe they only went for smaller sharks. But Port and Starboard have gone for bigger sharks in the past. In 2017, one of the sharks that washed up on False Bay with their liver removed was a 16-foot, almost 5-meter female called Khaleesi. Now you might be saying, oh well, they haven't gone for a 20-footer, or a 6.1-meter female. And as far as I know, we don't have evidence of them going for a female that big. But that may just be due to the fact that 20-footers are rare. I mean, Deep Blue is world famous because she might be 20 feet long, or close to it. And Howler Girl also went viral, as she is also pretty close to that size. But that's because they are exceptionally large white sharks. 20 foot is not the average. And not that many orca are known to hunt white sharks, so Maybe they just haven't crossed paths? I mean, sure, a 20-foot female should be stronger and more powerful than a 16-footer, but also less agile? Also, I don't have exact measurements of port and starboard. I don't think they've been measured, but they were estimated to be about 20 years old in 2021, so that's 2 years ago. And according to the Center of Whale Research, I know orca are more dolphins, but they reach maturity at about 25 years old. So they're probably somewhat close to fully grown. They might still be growing a bit. So how big can male orcas get? Well, it depends on the morphotype. It was once thought that the South African orca were type A, the biggest kind of orca. But according to research in an article in the African Journal of Marine Science, they may actually be a different morphotype known as the flat-toothed orca, which are considered to be a little bit smaller than type A, with adults being about 1 to 1.5 meters smaller in length, so that's about 3 or 5 feet shorter. Okay, so the largest male orca ever recorded was 32 feet or 9.8 meters, but the average is about 20 to 26 feet, 6 to 8 meters. Now mine is about 1 to 1.5 meters for the flat-toothed morphotype, which is what port and starboard are, and you probably have a couple of orca that aren't that much longer than a maxed out 20-foot female white shark. Maybe a little longer, but it's not all about length. We also have to consider overall size. A 20-foot female white shark might weigh about 4,400 pounds, just under 2,000 kilos, but these orca, being around the same length, or probably a little bit longer, would weigh closer to 11,000 pounds, or 5,000 kilos. And again, it's more about the fact that the orca use a coordinated attack and put the shark into tonic immobility, basically like a trance that gives them the edge. Now, maybe it's harder to do that with a massive female white shark, but if they really wanted to, I bet they could, especially if they were working with even more orca, as we've seen Starboard do in the drone footage. All of this is to say that even if it was a very big female white shark, I don't think she'd have a very good chance. But what about that female in the documentary? She showed up after the males fled. Doesn't it seem like she seems confident about encountering an orca? Well, not exactly. Sure, that's the way it seems at first, but if we keep watching, we see she keeps her distance from the cage, and also the males didn't really fully flee. They backed off from the cage, but kept circling from a greater distance, like the female. It seems the sounds made all the sharks a little more hesitant and cautious, male and female. Okay, well then how did the South African female and the New Zealand male survive the orca attack? Well, I have my own little theory about that. So let's put some pieces together. So we've already said, if an orca attack happens, white sharks seem to scatter, get away as quick as they can. Now, from what I've read, it seems white sharks can swim up to about 25 miles an hour, or 40 kilometers, or maybe up to 30 miles an hour, 50 kilometers in short bursts. Orca, however, can apparently go up to 35 miles an hour, or 56 kilometers. So I guess to get away in time, the sharks will need a head start. So if they smell a slick, or hear the orca, or whatever it is, and go right away, they should be able to escape. But what if you are the first shark that gets attacked? What if somehow the orca are able to sneak up on you or ambush you? Well, then the shark will probably die. Even if it tries to swim away, orca have been known to pursue for an hour. But let's try and think about this in more three-dimensional terms. The paper on the South African female white shark states, "The marks could have been caused by the teeth in the lower jaw of an orca trying to grab the shark from above." And while I'm not certain of the angle of attack on the New Zealand male, the fact that the bite marks are on its dorsal fin make me believe it was attacked from above as well. Now, if the tactic for white sharks is to get away from orca, then if you are being attacked from up above, then the direction of escape would be down. And finally, we see the shark's advantage. Orca might be bigger and faster, and they have that oh-so-useful mammalian intelligence, but being a mammal comes with a cost. They have to surface to get air. It seems the maximum an orca can hold its breath is for about 15 minutes, but again, if it dives to pursue a shark, it will have to swim back up the same distance it went down so it can get air. So if we simplify it and assume it is swimming the same speed up as it does back down, a bit of an assumption, it can really only dive for about 7 minutes. That's not even considering that it would be more oxygen starved from chasing. Also consider that Orca can go to a max depth of about 1,000 meters, which is 3,280 feet, and the great whites have been recorded at 1,200 meters, 3,937 feet, and another advantage becomes clear. So the shark just has to avoid the orca and swim down for a few minutes, and the orca will have to turn around. And then the shark can keep swimming deeper and just swim away. If other sharks are able to swim away for almost an hour in a more horizontal position, maybe diving in a more vertical position for a few minutes is enough. To be clear, I'm not saying the white sharks like Red Ender's Game and know that the mammalian orca have to surface. All I'm saying is they try to swim away from the direction of attack. So the great whites fight back? Yeah, they probably do, or at least try to. I'm sure a shark would be pretty angry if thought it was about to get eaten, but I don't think it's an effective defense. Port and Starboard don't seem to have any bite marks, so it seems they are good at avoiding the jaws. I'm sure most, if not all the sharks that they killed, probably tried to fight back in their last moments, but now they are dead. Sometimes the smartest thing to do is run. Now, CDs, if you're watching this video, I hope my ideas aren't disappointing. I know you've looked into this a lot, and you might have a completely different perspective, so I look forward to hearing your thoughts. I really appreciate your comments, they are always interesting and informative, and I also really appreciate that you pointed me in the direction of looking into this topic. Now, let me finish with a big disclaimer. I'm not a shark scientist, I'm just a guy on YouTube who likes sharks, and a lot of this is just based on some ideas and speculation. Obviously, a lot more research and studies are needed, and actual scientists should be the ones interpreting that data. It does seem that more orca are picking up the white shark hunting habit. Like I said, Starboard was within that group of five, so maybe orca are teaching other orca how to hunt white sharks. Perhaps the number of white shark attacks will increase as time goes on. Maybe they will target a 20-footer, and she'll fight them off, and I'll be proven completely wrong. I do hope that these orca and deep blue never cross paths though. Like I said before, 20 footers are pretty rare nowadays, and it would be a shame to lose a magnificent shark like her. Again, thanks to my patrons for their support, and thanks for watching.